How sincere is the government in wanting to better your life when they dismiss out of hand this plan for creating jobs and enterprise in a new Singapore economy? Do not believe them when they tell you that drawing down on the reserves will lead to inflation. This is an investment for the future that is affordable from the Singapore reserves. We will not even need to increase taxation to achieve this plan. The government has also received additional tax revenues from the two new casinos. Think about inflation for yourselves. The high cost of living, is that due, as the government would have you believe, to the higher food prices everywhere? The government wants you to believe them when they tell you they have no control over the high cost of living in Singapore. Think about what you pay out every day. What hurts your pocket? It is GST, ERP, MRT, COE, and high petrol taxes. These are certainly things that the government can control. Even your CPF does not work in your favor. It means you take home a lower wage than your foreign counterpart. And the interest of 2.5% per annum does not even cover inflation at 5%, which means you are actually paying another 2.5% out of your CPF to the government every year. And the price of housing. Who controls the price of the new HDB flats in Singapore? We do not import housing. Today, we met an old man in a coffee shop, and he told us this. Why do we need HDB prices to be high? If we make any money, we are making money from our children and our grandchildren. It is their money that we are making. My friends, this old man from the coffee shop is true talent. He can see what Minister Mah Bow Tan cannot see. So, it is not true when they say they cannot do anything about the high cost of living. They can, but why don't they? They can raise their own salaries by more than 20%, but did you get a pay rise of even 5% last year? Even if you did, that is no pay rise at all, since prices have also gone up by 5%. Look at the GDP growth last year, 14.5%. Did your salary rise by 14.5%? Did your quality of life improve by 14.5%? Yet, the minister's bonuses, up to 8 months' bonus, are pegged to GDP growth. Yesterday, Dr. Vivian Balakrishnan said that his ministry gives $500 million to people who need help. That is wonderful. You will not hear us say we have a problem with that kind of expenditure by the MCYS. He says this shows they are not a stingy government. Last month, the government increased the president's salary by 20%. By $890,000 a year. That is 74,000 Singapore dollars a month more. Yet, also last month, Dr. Balakrishnan increased the public assistance allowance for the poor by $30 a month. This was an increase of 10%. So the president increased by 20%, the poor increased by 10%. And when MP Lily Neo asked if this could be increased by more, Dr. Balakrishnan said, "How much do you want? Do you want 3 meals in a hawker center, food court, or restaurant?" Now, I try to make my $30 go as far as possible, but you and I both know that it does not go very far at all. So, my friends, I would like to say, as my mother tells me, actions speak louder than words. This is an email one of the constituents here in Bukit Panjang sent us. He said, "I am a senior management staff with a big global firm, running vendor contracts that are worth millions of dollars. Every 3 years, we will review the vendor's performance to see if we want to renew their contract. If any existing vendor comes to me and tells me he can improve this or that, the first question I will ask him is, why didn't you do all these improvements during the previous contract? And the second question I ask him will be, if you are unable to fulfill these in the previous contract, how would I be able to trust you this time?" This is what the PAP promised in the 2006 elections. They promised to create opportunities for all Singaporeans, give our young the best start in life, encourage every citizen to play a role, do more for lower income Singaporeans, and provide affordable health care for all Singaporeans. Now they tell you, these are long-term problems. They had the past 5 years. How much time do they need? 10 years? 20 years? Do you want to wait 20 years to see the results? Do you trust that they have a plan? What is their plan? We can only hope it is not more casinos. We were glad to hear Dr. Vivian Balakrishnan give you, the residents of Bukit Panjang, such a long and careful explanation of his MCYS expenditure. Last night, we were the ones who asked him the question. We are glad you were able to hear his reply. It is us, the opposition, who is making them accountable now to you, the people. Ask yourselves, do you only want an explanation once every 5 years, or every year? We are glad that you, the residents of Bukit Panjang, have benefited from the opening of the new Senja Cashew Community Center. It is indeed to be appreciated and enjoyed. It is unfortunate that the MCYS overspent their YOG budget by $300 million. Because this money could have been used to build 10 more community centers for the country, like your Senja Cashew CC. Fellow Singaporeans, here in this election, we give you a choice. We have a plan for our future. Read it, and you will feel hope stirring in your heart. We ask for your trust. Give us this chance to build a better future for you and your loved ones. We are here to be your voices. My voice is not my own. It is yours to speak for your needs, your hopes, your future. You don't need to worry. We are not here to wayang, to be actors on a stage. We would never obstruct any policy that would be in your interest. Never stand in the way of any scheme to benefit those in need. But we have the courage needed to be your voice, raised in defense of your needs, raised against policies and plans that go against your interests, that overlook your contributions and your cries for help. You don't need to worry. Your housing estates will not suddenly become cheaper than other neighborhoods because you vote for the opposition. Your flats will not become less desirable if not upgraded further. Look at the housing prices in Potong Pasir and Hougang. They have risen along with all the HDB flat prices in Singapore. Otherwise, at least our young people would have the option of buying affordable flats in these areas. So do not feel fear. Instead, let the government feel ashamed. Ashamed for failing to provide sheltered walkways and lifts for the elderly and the young who live in Potong Pasir and Hougang. Just because the residents, the Singaporeans in these communities exercise their vote to support men who stand up for their rights, for their freedoms, and for their beliefs.